do so many balancing and send me. Okay, and Sally, again your duty is to recall me or memorize me that I have to send you the solved questions of chapter 1. There are so many solved balancing equations. So I will send you so many solved balancing equations. On behalf of these solved equations, you can check out yourself that how are you doing good or are you doing bad or how you are doing. Okay, you can check yourself by balancing. So remember me, memorize me to send me two things. Light and second chapter 1, that is chemical reactions. Okay, now we are moving further and we studied that how to balance chemical reactions. Okay, now we are moving further in balancing. Okay, suppose we have a reaction that is Fe plus H2O, that is Fe3O4 plus H2. Okay, we have to balance this, and I have balanced this, that is 3, 4, and 4. Okay, now this is balanced chemical reaction. But before balancing, okay, this reaction is known as skeletal reaction, that is skeleton. Have you seen a skeleton? That is nothing other than a skeleton. If you have seen a skeleton of someone, you can see the skeleton of human, skeleton of goat, skeleton of cow, skeleton of lizard, skeleton of goat, skeleton of lion. Okay, but everything is not clear. So the reaction which is provided to you or which will be provided to you in your examination is skeletal reaction. You have to balance this. Okay, I'm just balancing this. Okay, now this reaction is not fulfilled yet. You have to write down the symbols. What are the symbols? The symbols are that ferrous is a solid thing. We know that iron is present in solid condition. This is water and it is present in gas condition. This is rust. It is also present in solid condition. And this is hydrogen gas. We know it is present in gas condition. So after balancing, you have to symbolize them. If you know the symbol, okay. So this is the symbol. I'm telling you about some more symbols. This is for gas. This is for solid. This is for liquid. This is for aqueous. What is aqueous? Something which is soluble in water, like we have added sugar in water, we have added salt in water, that is known as aqueous. Okay, water plus anything, water plus any soluble thing. Okay, that is known as aqueous solution. Okay, next, this is again the sign of gas. Okay, this is again the sign of gas. Okay, it means it is gone away. Okay, this is the sign of heat. Okay, this is the sign of heat. Now, second thing is that is catalyst. What is catalyst? Okay, now write down what is catalyst. Catalyst is a substance that can be added to a reaction to increase the reaction rate without getting consumed in the process. That is catalyst. Now, what is catalyst? First of all, write down the definition of catalyst. Suppose this is H2O, okay, and I'm doing a reaction and I want to use heat to make water vapor, so it will get breakdown into H2 plus O. Okay, so this is the sign of heat. Okay, so this is my catalyst. Heat is my catalyst. Okay, second, I'm doing again a reaction, that is I'm taking carbon monoxide, and this is the definition of catalyst. A substance Yeah, definition. A substance that can be added to a reaction to increase the reaction rate without getting consumed in the process. Write down.
Temperature, pressure, and sunlight.
Okay. Now, you know, in this reaction, water, I used heat. Okay, heat is my catalyst. Okay, so in the formation of H2O, okay, heat, I cannot perform this reaction without heat. I have to use heat to perform this reaction. But heat is, heat was involved, but heat is not in the product. Okay, the product means that what I have used and what I got, okay, heat is not involved in this. I'm using this. One more thing, okay, I want to tell you very simple thing, okay. Have you eaten your mayonnaise and have you eaten your spreads? There are so many type of spreads, peanut butter and cheese, and have you eaten dalda, ghee? Okay, there are so many type of these type of things, mayonnaise, cheese spreads, dalda, peanut butter spread, okay. All of them are most probably made up of oil. Okay, oil. Okay, we use oil, okay, and we use hydrogen, okay, and we use nickel. What do we use? Nickel or platinum. Remember these two things. Okay, and this, by this oil, we can get our mayonnaise. Okay, we can get our cheese spread. Okay, we can got all these things. Okay, so hydrogen is something. Hydrogen is not a catalyst. Okay, I can write like oil plus hydrogen. Okay, I use this. But what about this nickel and platinum? Okay, we cannot found platinum in our mayonnaise and we cannot found nickel or platinum in our cheese spread. Okay, so where they gone? They are just used to formation of this product without getting involved. They are not involved in our products. They are just catalyst. They improve the rate of reaction. What does it mean? They increase the reaction rate without getting consumed. So you can isolate, or they are not even consumed, they are just useful to perform the reaction or to increase the rate of reaction perfectly. They are not utilized, that are catalysts are not utilized, they are just helpers. Okay, if I'm giving you one thing, okay, and I'm getting this thing, okay, if I'm using a catalyst, okay, the catalyst helps to get me B and C, whatever my product is. Catalyst, you cannot find this catalyst. Maybe the catalyst is E. Okay, you cannot find the catalyst in my product, that is B or C. B or C can be anything I want to get from A. Okay, this E helps us to get B and C very quickly, very without this E, without this catalyst, I can find B and C, but it will take hours and hours and hours. But with the help of E, I can get this in seconds. Okay, so it helps me to enhance the rate of reaction, but you cannot find E in these things. So you can isolate this and it can also utilize for the performance of other type of reaction. That is the use of catalysts, that are catalysts. So there are three type of catalysts: temperature, pressure, and sunlight. Temperature means heat. Okay, so this is another carbon monoxide, that is gas, and I'm having water. Okay, that is liquid. 2H2O, that is hydrogen gas. Sorry, I wrote some wrong. 2H2, that is hydrogen gas. Okay, and I'm getting this. Okay, I'm getting this. Okay, this is alcohol, and I'm getting this on 340 atmospheric pressure. That is the unit of pressure. Okay, without pressure, I can get this. Okay, but I cannot get this much easily. It will take hours, but with the help of catalyst, I can get this in seconds. So this is my catalyst. Okay. Catalyst enhance the rate of reaction. Okay. So I have to write this catalyst. Okay. So first of all, when you are provided with the skeletal reaction, you have to balance this first. You have to symbolize them and you have to write down if any catalyst has been used. Okay, you have to write down if any catalyst has been used. Okay, so write catalyst. Okay, three rules. Now, fourth rule is whatever you are getting, maybe I'm writing the reaction that is H2O and I'm by using heat as a catalyst. I'm getting something that is H2 plus O. Okay, I'm getting this. Now, this is known as my LHS site. That is left hand side, and this is my right hand side. Okay, on LHS side, I have always a reactant. I have always reactant. The thing which is present at left hand side is known as reactant. And it can be 1, 2, 3, whatever. It can be 2, it can be 3, it can be 1. Okay, right now it is 1. Okay, and at the right hand side, I will have products. I will have products. Also, it can be 1, 2, or 3. Here, we are getting 2 products. One is hydrogen and another is oxygen. Okay, I'm writing another reaction. That is the reaction of photosynthesis. Aqueous, that means the carbon dioxide is present in aqueous medium. Okay, the catalyst, can you tell me the catalyst of photosynthesis reaction? Can you tell me the catalyst of photosynthesis reaction? Yeah, very good. Sunlight and one more thing. That is liquid. Okay, so the catalyst are sunlight for sure and chlorophyll. Very good. Very good, Salya. Okay, so there are 2 catalysts. Okay, so these sites are my reactants. They are 2. You can see. Reactants, they are 2. One is CO2 and one is 12H2O. And here at right hand side, I have 3 products. This is my first product, this is my second product, and this is my third product. Okay. Same time, sunlight and chlorophyll are used. Okay. But you know that they are catalysts and you can find, can you find sunlight here? Can you find sunlight here? Can you find chlorophyll here? They are just used. Okay. So this is known as they are catalysts. Okay, they are reactants and they are products. So the next rule is to identify and to write down the what is the reactant and what are the product. They can be more than one, both side. Okay, so this is the rule of writing chemical equation. First of all, you should be provided with a skeleton reaction. Then you have to balance this. Then you have to write symbols. If you have used any catalyst or the book mentioned about the catalyst, then you have to write the catalyst. And finally, you have to answer that it was the reactant and it is my product. Okay. Now, I'm moving to another type of topic. And one more thing during balancing. Okay. Whatever you are writing here. Okay. You should use a coefficient. You know what is coefficient? That is whole number. Okay. You can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. But you cannot write 1.1, 1.2, 1.5, 1.6 here. Okay. You know that they are coefficients. They are whole number. You can see that they are whole numbers. They are whole numbers. Okay. So don't write coefficient anyhow. Remember this. Okay. Now we are moving to another thing.
And this is most interesting thing. There will be so many interesting reactions. So these are the type of chemical reactions. These are the type of chemical reactions. Okay, all these are chemical reactions. So what is the definition of chemical reaction? First of all, write down this. What is the basic definition of chemical reaction? That atoms of one element do not change into another element, nor do atoms disappear from the mixture or appear from elsewhere. Chemical reaction involve the breaking and making of bonds between atoms to produce new substance. Okay, write down this. Okay, and this we will go step by step, and we will learn about all these type of reactions. Don't panic, it is super simple. It is very simple. And if you can learn the chapter light, you can do anything. Okay, just write the definition of chemical reaction. You can find the definition of chemical reactions from anywhere, from internet or from any other book. But these chemical reactions, I have found this definition very clear and really relevant with our topic. Write down this. Definition of chemical reaction. Okay, I'm changing the page. Now, what does it say? Atoms of one element do not change into another element. Okay, what does it mean? First of all, if I'm writing very simple thing, I'm taking, okay, I'm taking H2O, and you can write this H2 plus O. Okay, first of all, what does it say? Atoms of one element do not change into another element. That means hydrogen here will be hydrogen here and oxygen here will be oxygen here. It doesn't mean that if we are doing something, or I'm taking another example, we have done this so many times before. I'm taking another example, that is 3Fe plus 4H2O plus Fe3O4 plus 4H2. Okay, this is reaction. I'm using Fe here, definitely I'm finding Fe here. I'm using H2 here, definitely I'm finding H2 and O here, hydrogen, oxygen here. I cannot find something like magnesium and something like calcium and something like nickel, because if it is not used, how can you get them? Okay, you can get atoms with changing in their numbers, that before and after it was ferrous before and it was Fe3 here, okay, and after balancing it become 3Fe, okay, it's okay. But it is not possible that I'm using ferrous here and suddenly I will get magnesium here. It is not possible anyhow. So this is our first rule. Second, nor do atoms disappear or reappear from elsewhere. Okay, if I'm doing something with Fe here, definitely I will find Fe here. Okay, it is not possible that if I'm doing something with Fe here and suddenly I will not find Fe here and it will disappear from whole equation. No, it will not get disappear. Okay, what is the third thing? Chemical bonds are forming and breaking. That is very simple thing. Here the ferrous is alone, and here you can see the ferrous with oxygen. So ferrous go with oxygen. Okay, so there are formation of bonds and there are breaking down of bonds. Okay, so here ferrous come with oxygen. Okay, and hydrogen is alone here. Here you can see hydrogen is with oxygen, and here hydrogen is alone. Here you can see the ferrous is alone, and here you can see the ferrous is with oxygen. Okay, so there is formation of bonds, there is breaking of bonds, and those atoms which are involved, you can find these atoms here. They will not get disappear. You cannot find anything coming suddenly that you haven't used calcium in whole reaction and suddenly you will find calcium is coming out. So it is not possible. This is our chemical reaction, and this is the definition of chemical reaction. Now we are going to do some chemical reactions, and all the chemical reactions are super interesting. Okay, so let's get started. First chemical reaction is combination reaction. Okay, now what is combination? If you combine 2, 3, A plus B will form C. Okay, definitely it will be reactant. Left side is reactant. Okay, and it will be my product. Okay, you can get more. If I'm using A plus B, maybe I can get C plus D. It is okay. You can get 2, 3. Reactant can be more than 2. Or products can be more than 2. 2 or more than 2. Okay. So let's take an example. I'm writing CaO here. Okay, that is a substance, so considered as A. Okay, it is alone. And this CaO is known as quick lime. Okay, that is known as quick lime. That is sometimes known as whitewash powder. That is calcium oxide. Okay, this quick lime is a common name. And this is whitewash powder. Okay, sometimes we call it chuna. Okay, and this is water. Okay. And finally, both of them will form CaOH whole twice, that is slaked lime. Okay, it was B. And finally, we got C. Okay, so this is the first chemical combination reaction, and the heat is involved. Okay, heat is involved. That means heat is coming out. If I do this reaction in a test tube, I have added CaO, and if I add water, okay, and finally there will be reaction, and that this CaOH twice will come out. Okay, this is calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide. Okay, why I wrote this? I told you about this formation of chemical formula. Why I wrote this calcium hydroxide? That is calcium hydroxide. This is calcium, this is hydroxide. The valency of calcium is 2. The valency of hydroxide is 1. I told you from where I got the valencies. Okay, just cross this. Can cross their valencies 2. And this is how I can get the formula. Okay, you have to learn the valencies till 20 atomic numbers, that is hydrogen, helium, lithium, barium, boron, carbon, from your 9th class. And you also have to learn the valencies of these hydroxide and nitrates and all these things, which you can get from your 9th class book. I have told you this before. Okay, so I'm getting heat. That means I cannot touch this test tube because it will increase or raise in this temperature. Okay, I cannot touch this, or if I touch this, I can burn myself, or I can feel the heat which is coming out because this reaction is releasing heat. That's why these type of reactions are also known as exothermic. That means these reactions are releasing heat outside. The heat will come outside. This product will generate heat with itself. That's why this is known as exothermic reaction. Okay, so write down the form, the equation of combination reaction. The combination reaction, when two or more substances, okay, it can be element or compound, combined to form single product. Doesn't mean that always single product has to come out. There can be more than two products come out. Okay, that is known as combination reaction. Okay, if I use this again, okay, this is the combination reaction itself. Again, I'm using a combination reaction. Okay, now this is my A reactant, and I have added this with water, CO2, sorry, carbon dioxide. Okay, this is calcium hydroxide, and this is product, my reactant A and reactant B. Okay, both of will form, that will something C, that is CaCO3, that is calcium carbonate. Okay, and this is calcium carbonate is also a confirmatory test of CO2. If you remember that, how we can taste the presence of carbon dioxide then take carbon dioxide and flush this carbon dioxide in a container which is having this slaked lime or calcium hydroxide, and it will form calcium carbonate. And this calcium carbonate is having a curdy appearance. It look like curd when it is with water. Okay, this is my another product. So it will look like curd when it is water, and when it is with water, it would look like curdy appearance. And when it is dry, it look like eggshell. If you remember, eggshell is made up of calcium carbonate. Chalk is made up of calcium carbonate. Marbles are made up of calcium carbonate. If you remember this. Okay, so this is my new combination. Okay, this is combination reaction. So now this is product reactant A, this is reactant B, and this is my product, and the another thing, water is also formed. So these are two reactions. Okay, don't forget the name slaked lime and quick lime. Okay, most of us do this. Even I sometimes do this. Okay, I just forgot to write their names, and sometimes I get confused what is quick lime and what is slaked lime. So you have to remember this, that how slack lime is formed and how quick lime is formed. Okay. Now we will be back after 20 to 30 seconds. Okay. Now the people, those who are making their DJ night today, okay, the people are playing English music, and even they can't speak Hindi properly. Okay, they can't understand English. And they can't even speak Hindi properly, and even they can't understand English properly, but they are playing English songs and English music. So disgusting, a disaster.